you brought the Orphic Hammer. The Prince of the Comet is not dead. The Prince of the Comet will come again. The Prince of the Comet will liberate us from the Lich Queen's tyranny. The prophecy is one step closer to fruition.
Gith's son will soon ride against Vlakith Voss, and I will follow him into battle.
And you will wield the greatest gift Mother Gith ever granted her dauntless children.
A silver sword. I will carry it for the honor of Gith, the great liberator, and her unforgotten son.
Iztik, now that you have the hammer, you must find a way to enter the astral prism. Once inside, smash Orpheus's bonds. His cry will shake the plains, and I will fly to your aid. The Prince of the Comet will sear the heavens again. First we'll defeat the Absolute, then we let the Lich Queen tremble.
Think again. I will not permit your entry. Even if you could, you would relinquish your mind to the Elder Brain in so doing. When I am done with the Gith Princeling, you may do with him as you like, but not a moment before.
Questions, Iztik? You seem to be lost in thought. The Prince of the Comet aches for Githyanki liberation more than he abhors Geich. He might seethe when you free him. He might gnash his teeth and slander your name. But he will see reason. I promise you. Yes, but you will meet this challenge, as you've met so many others. Iztik, friend to Orpheus. Together we will end the Elder Brain which shakes this city. Then I turn my sights to Vlakith, the Queen of Deceit. When you break Prince Orpheus free, his psionic cry will alert us. I will fly to your side. Together we will fell the Elder Brain and thwart the grand design.
Indolence breeds madness.
Since I was old enough to hold a blade, I've dreamt of wielding a silver sword. The swords cleave both meat and mind, body and brain. To swing one, mesmerizing. To be slain by one, agonizing. Everyone I bleed with the sword will be my tribute to Prince Orpheus.
Recall another fact about silver swords. The Githyanki forbid their use by all other peoples.
Only Gith's children may wield swords of silver, unless a Githyanki grants the right in exceptional circumstance. The Illithid Grand Design nears. The true heir is shackled. These are exceptional circumstances. I grant my allies the right to my silver. Certainly not, or the Prince's honor guard would have already fractured his prison. Only the Orphic Hammer can break Orpheus free. A Kithrak's silver sword is more than a weapon. extension of your will, an entire limb unto itself. You merely need to think strike, and it strikes. The sword carves the correct path and carries your arm with it. The ancient slates tell us that each sword holds a fragment of the living gate, a flesh portal made from the stuffs of nightmare.
The terrible living gate, thinner than a lamb's hair and hidden deep beneath the Feywild.
The silver injures the body. The gate's flesh injures the mind. A formidable weapon against Gaeth.
Thank you. interviews, politics, gossip. All of it gets in that bloody Walter's mouth rag.
These flowers are quite vivid, not to mention pungent. Not to my liking.
Are there no flowers in Tunerath?
In the City of Death, the Malar cultivate the fruiting bodies that sprout from the corpses of the slain.
Huh. I'd rather get them from my florist in Waterdeep. It's all the same to you.
Let's get on with it.
A good day to you, madam. I apologize, but Lady Janneth is not currently welcoming visitors. If you are here with regards to her recent marriage, you may leave any gifts or warm wishes with me, and I will ensure she receives them. Forgive me. As you can hear, Lady Janneth is indisposed at present. Please come back another time. I assure you, absolutely nothing untoward is happening inside. Lady Janneth wishes for some time alone with her new spouse and has sent her staff on holiday accordingly. In ordinary circumstances, I'd appreciate her generosity more fully, but, well, I prefer to be here for when she changes her mind. Were you to try and enter, there'd be nothing I could do to stop you. After all, I am on holiday. Do as you wish.
could barely sleep for a 10-day.
Nothing will stand in my way.
My faith protects me.
Death won't take me yet.
To strike. Let my name be known. Make way.
Allow me to demonstrate. With ease.
To meet your maker.
Swiftly now.
Victory awaits.
Come on, can't stay idle.
Sean.
You pick.
picked the wrong fight, friend.
Wits and blades, always sharp.
But to keep going. You've made a grave mistake. Remember that the gods are watching me.
Meet sorcery.
Eat this!
Swift and lethal. You bow.
please, Mistra.
I am Fury. I am Death. Check for anything useful.
The only way out is through. Fall by my hand.
should I do? On the move.
Cutting to the chase.
Can't afford to let up. On the move. I'm ready.
Can't give up now. That took the edge off.
Is the grunting of a swine. Come closer so I can rip out your filthy tongue.
Stop this. I love you, Oscar, and I know you love me.
It's your gold I love, hogwife. But all the riches in Faerun would not be enough to make a life with you worth living.
Oh, gods, aid me. He does not mean the things he says. You! Help subdue him. But be gentle. He's not to blame. not that I'm ungrateful for your help, but... Wait. Your face is familiar to me. Yes, I've seen it before on Oscar's sketches. You're the one who saved him from the Zentarim. Not long after the wedding, he lost his appetite, fell into dark moods. He started to avoid my company entirely. Artistic temperament, I thought. But it worsened. He became violent. Called me some rather imaginative names. I hesitate to say it, but I think you're right. Something supernatural has taken hold of him. Oscar has been possessed. I used to be. Now I'm his wife. We married not a 10 day ago. Things have changed rather a lot since then. I can't come within arm's reach without him trying to strangle me. And he calls me such vile things. It hates everyone, but it loathes me. It's not him. I know he would never hurt me. And I promised I would let no harm come to him. As you can see, I've already failed. It's obvious he needs more help than I can give. Please, you saved him once. You must find a way to cure him. I can't tell anyone about this. It was hard enough to keep it from the servants. The city is rife with paranoia. If word got out about his condition, well, the Steelwatch are hardly known for showing mercy. I need someone to look into this quietly. It's the only chance he has. Oscar's behavior began to change shortly after the wedding. He became withdrawn, working obsessively up in his atelier. I tried to take him some food, but I couldn't cross the threshold. It was as though the house itself didn't want me up there. Whatever this thing is, it doesn't want anyone going up there. I swear, it's in the walls, watching.